can't sign into an account because your authenticator app is on a lost phone, here's what to do. It is vital to protect accounts with two-factor authentication. If your password gets leaked, 2FA will safeguard your account against hacking. One of the most convenient 2FA methods is to use an app that generates one-time codes, such as Google Authenticator and the like. But what if your phone and along with it the authenticator app gets lost, broken or stolen? In that case, you have several options. If you're still logged into the account on another device, you may be in luck. Open your account settings and reset the authenticator that is linked to the app on the new phone. The item you need is usually somewhere on the security tab. For example, this option works with Google accounts if you're logged into even one of the company's apps, such as YouTube. Some services even display the secret key or QR code of the authenticator in the settings. In that case, simply enter the secret key or scan the QR code in the authenticator app on the new device and you're all set. Unfortunately, this method doesn't always work. The problem is that not all services use the same settings in the web version as in the mobile app. The option you need might simply not be operant on the device where you're logged in. If you're not logged in elsewhere and your smartphone is lost, you won't be able to recover the authenticator. What you can do now is restore access to your account. If it's an account with a major public service like Google or Facebook and your account is linked to your email or phone number, you can use an alternative authentication method. Just start the account login process by entering your username and password, and when you need to enter a one-time code from the authenticator app, look for a try another way or similar link. Select the most convenient option and wait for the code to arrive. It shouldn't take long and soon you'll be able to sign in to your account. If the loss of the authenticator blocks your account access, for example, with a corporate or small public service, contact a local administrator or support service and explain what happened. You'll most likely need to prove you are the real owner of the account. When you are finally able to log into your account, link the authenticator to the app on your new smartphone. And so as not to have to repeat everything the next time you lose your smartphone, create a backup right away. I'll tell you some ways to do that, but if you want to dig deeper, read the article on Kaspersky Daily. The link is in the description. Manually store secret keys or QR codes in a safe place. When you set up authentication, the app creates a secret key on which to base new one-time codes. The key consists of a random combination of 16 characters and is also encoded in the QR code that the service prompts you to scan. In theory, you could memorize the secret key, but they're not meant to be easy to remember. Instead, store yours safely, for example, in your password manager's secure notes. Alternatively, you can save the QR code as an image and safely store it in Kaspersky Password Manager. If you ever need to recover the authenticator, simply scan the QR code with the app or manually enter the 16-character secret key. Cloud sync the authenticator app. Most popular authenticator apps let you store secret keys in the cloud and automatically sync up authenticators across devices. With Microsoft Authenticator, you can use your Microsoft account. If you don't have one, you will have to create one. Just know this app has a compatibility problem with backups from other OSs. To learn more about this issue, click the link in the description. Expert tokens already created in the authenticator. Google Authenticator provides an option to export tokens that are already created in the app and import them on another device. Click on the three dots at the top of the screen, select Export Accounts, and mark the accounts you need. After that, a huge QR code containing all of the selected tokens appears on the screen. All that remains is to take a screenshot and save the image securely in your password manager. When it comes to backing up your authenticator app, you have loads of choices. We've talked about some of them, but you can learn more at the link in the description. Thanks for watching. Remember, if you make backups, you don't have to worry about losing your data.